There are several factors that affect the variable fixed cost classification. First, the same cost can sometimes be variable and other times fixed based on the terms of the related agreements. The commission paid to a sales agent is a variable cost if it is a percentage from the achieved sales, and is a fixed cost when it is a fixed monthly amount regardless of the sales volume achieved. And if the commission includes a fixed monthly figure in addition to a percentage of the achieved sales volume, then it is a mixed cost, which are costs that include both variable and fixed elements. Management should include more fixed costs in the cost structure if a business growth is expected, and more variable costs if a decline is expected. Second, the cost object. The depreciation expense for a car is a fixed cost regardless of the distance covered by this car, and is a variable cost if more cars are added. So, it is a fixed cost if the cost object is the distance covered by the car, and is a variable cost if the cost object is the number of cars. Third, costs in the short run versus the long run. A cost might be fixed in the short run, also called the relevant range, but becomes variable in the long run. The depreciation expense for a production facility is fixed during the current year, but becomes variable over a period of 5 years as the company builds more production facilities to meet the expected increase in the demand for its products. The instructor's fees paid is fixed up to 250 students, and becomes variable beyond that, as more instructors should be hired to cover the increase in the number of students. Also, a variable cost like, for example, direct materials needed for production, might not remain purely variable over the long run when higher volumes of production are achieved, as better purchase prices might be negotiated with suppliers for increased business with them.